Dimmed energy occurs when government fails to buy electricity from generation facilities despite availability. Most of the times, this has been caused by lack of infrastructure like transmission lines.
The main constraint has been the delay in the construction of the main evacuation plant, the transmission line. The transmission line from this particular plant to a substation in Angangura, all the way to Gulu and ultimately to Kole, in interconnecting with the grid.
About a fortnight ago, Parliament ordered an investigation into dimmed energy as government continues to pay billions of shillings to private generation facilities. During the visit to the facility, MPs asked developers of Achua power plants in Pade district to furnish it with key documents like its power purchase agreement and invoices.
So there are certain documents, particularly the power purchase agreement, that we want to look into to ascertain what was agreed between government and the developer of this plant. Actually, there are a cascade of three plants here.
Dimmed energy is one of the thorny issues that have emerged in the liberalized electricity supply industry. According to the latest Auditor General's report, Uganda lost up to 102 billion in dimmed energy payments last financial year. This figure is likely to increase.
With dimmed energy, we are a developing country. We cannot afford to be throwing 193 billion Ugandan shillings every year. You see, what prompted us is that we are just coming to the tail end of the budget process for the next financial year. But the Minister of Energy was requesting us for 193 billion Ugandan shillings to pay for dimmed energy.
Two plants, Achua 1 and Achua 2, commissioned in 2019 and 2021 respectively, with a combined installed capacity of 83 megawatts, are the biggest beneficiaries of dimmed energy. These were developed to completion without a ready transmission line to evacuate their
because if you aggregate what we are paying in dimmed energy for this plant that got ready in 2019, then it is really something that we must resolve as quickly as possible. It is disturbing to us. It is a very big cost paying for what you're not consuming.
Energy is here. It is being produced. We are paying for the power we are producing, but the Wananchis, the citizens, are not having power. So that's what we can to find out here. There is a lot here, let me tell you. So the government should invest a lot in transmission of power. Uganda Electricity Transmission Company, you are doing a disservice to Ugandans because taxpayers' money is being wasted here.
Government developed an emergency low voltage distribution line, but this, according to the company officials, can only evacuate 8 megawatts. In March, development of a transmission line and associated substations to evacuate the plants commenced. It's expected to be completed in June next year. However, this is facing a challenge with about 16 kilometers of the line passing through the government-owned Aswa Ranch. Story by Benon Ojambo for the news.